Okay, let's start talking about A and B.
Anatomic physiology is under the general category of biology. Bio refers to life or living things, so biology is the study of life. Anatomy basically is referring to the structure or the form, the pieces and parts of something. And physiology refers to the function, how those pieces and parts work. What do they do? There's this phrase, function follows form, or I actually learned it the other way, form follows function. What that means is if you change the form, if you change the shape, if you change the structure of something, then you're going to affect its function. Your ear, what's the function of the ear? I know it's to hold my glasses up. I'm just kidding. Yeah. So hearing, but what is it doing?
It's funneling the...
Funneling the
sound waves.
Yeah. So if you have a really small ear, or a really big ear, you know, the bigger the ear, what is it? Goldilocks? Red Riding Hood, right? What big ears you have, the better to... Yeah, exactly. Yeah. So, if you change the shape of something, you're going to change the function. Now, this is true on a macroscopic level, on a large, you know, gross scale, as well as down inside your cells at the chemical level. Anybody lactose intolerant that will admit it in public? You ever been with somebody who's lactose intolerant? Yeah. Lactose is the sugar that's found in dairy products and milk. When you see that OSE, think sugar, like glucose and sucrose. We'll talk a little bit more about those probably next week. Your digestive system produces an enzyme called lactase. So, when you see ASE, think enzyme. Now, we'll talk a little bit more in detail about what enzymes are, but this is a molecule that helps you digest, break down lactose. Now, people that are lactose intolerant, what happens is either they don't make enough of this enzyme, or they make this enzyme, but it's not shaped correctly. And so, therefore, it won't fit onto the sugar, and it can't break it down. Does that make sense? And what happens is the sugar stays in their small intestine. It doesn't get broken down. It gets to the large intestine, and the bacteria go, woohoo! You know. They're like, we like lactose. E. coli. Oh, man, that's a lactose-consuming little sucker. Produces gas, bloating. So this form follows function, or function follows form, means that these two things, how something is made and how it works, are interrelated. You change one, you're going to change the other. True on a macroscopic scale, true on a microscopic scale. And so that's why we study anatomy and physiology.